If you're new to electronics or microcontrollers, you might be wondering why these resistors are often used in conjunction with components like push buttons. Today, let's take a quick look at the basics behind these, which we call pull-up or pull-down resistors. The most important reason why these pull resistors are used is to prevent what is known as a floating pin, which microcontrollers like the Arduino have no idea how to interpret. Consider this simple switch setup. When a button is pressed, a voltage travels through the switch to the input pin on the microcontroller. When the microcontroller tries to read off the pin value, it sees the voltage and reports high. But what happens when the switch is not pressed? Now, the pin on the microcontroller is connected to nothing. This is what's known as a floating voltage, and in this state, any voltage detected on the pin is due to stray electromagnetic fields and other environmental sources, essentially turning it into an antenna. Because of this, there is no guarantee what voltage you'll see when you read off that pin, and in fact, it tends to fluctuate about, giving an inconsistent reading. Of course, push buttons are not the only components that display this behavior. Another place this could crop up is in transistor-based circuits. Since they work like switches, allowing or disallowing current flow from a power source, this same phenomenon happens. When a circuit is broken, the output pin, which may be the emitter or collector depending on the context, is essentially disconnected and floating. To solve the problem of a floating pin, we can pull it either up or down using a resistor. Instead of describing how that works, let's just look at an example. The same switch from before, but now paired with a pull-down resistor. Let's add a connection to ground through a resistor, which is of a fairly high resistance. Notice what happens now. When a switch is not pressed, the pin is connected to ground, registering a low reading. When a switch is pressed, the voltage source comes barreling through, overriding the effect of the pull resistor and registering a high reading on the pin as before. Now, there is no state in which the button is disconnected or floating. Both states of the button, whether it is pressed or not, gives a clear, well-defined reading. A resistor must be used. We can't simply connect the other end of the button to ground. Otherwise, whenever the button is pressed, we get a short circuit in which the voltage source comes in direct contact with ground. Remember Ohm's law. With very little resistance along the way, this allows a large amount of current to flow, creating a ton of heat throughout your microcontroller and any components in the way. And as you should very well know, letting the magic smoke out is bad news. In fact, that's why pull resistors are typically of fairly high resistance. We don't really need a ton of current to flow, particularly if all we want to do is to send a signal to a microcontroller. This is especially important if the circuit is meant to be closed a lot, because that means more time in which we have a connection between the voltage source and ground moving through that resistor. So far, we've seen pull-down resistors, which in context seems quite intuitive. When a button is pressed, we get a reading of high, and if not, low. But turns out, this is merely a convention. That's how we assign things. It doesn't have to be this way. Depending on your application, it may even be more useful to register low rather than high when a button is pressed. Interestingly, you do not need a different button. There are what is known as normally closed switches which will produce this effect. But even if you have a normally open switch, you can achieve that effect using the pull-up resistor, the twin sibling of the pull-down. Check out this connection, reverse the ground and voltage pin. Now, when a button isn't pressed, the pin sees the voltage via the pull-up resistor. When a button is pressed, it is the ground that comes through. We have effectively reversed the output of the button just by making connections a little differently. Whether we use a pull-up or pull-down resistor depends on the context of what we are building. To be exact, what you're really defining is, when the pin is disconnected, what do you want to assign it to? If you want it high, use a pull-up. If you want it low, then pull it down. Since it's such a common thing to do, many microcontrollers even allow you to activate a pull-up resistor on an input pin. For example, on the Arduino, you can simply set the pin mode of a pin to input pull-up, so that all floating connections will be automatically pulled up to high. In more advanced, time-sensitive applications in which the pull resistor must kick in quickly, a lower resistance may be used at the expense of a greater current flow when the opposite polarity is connected. This is called a strong pull-up or strong pull-down resistor. The converse is true. With a higher resistance, you get a slower response but less current flow, which we call a weak pull-up or weak pull-down resistor. Which version you use depends on the project you're trying to build, as well as how often you expect the circuit to be held closed. The wasted energy from the closed contact becomes significant if it's expected to be held closed for extended periods of time. For example, an emergency stop button would benefit from a strong pull, since we want a quick reaction, and it's rarely going to be pressed anyway, so an increased current draw isn't going to add up to much. And there you go! For a start, this explains what pull-up and pull-down resistors are, and what we use them for. There are of course more advanced considerations involved here, such as exactly which resistance to use, as well as some of the contextual background like why pull-up resistors are traditionally more common than pull-down resistors, all of which are out of scope for today's video. I've included a few links in the video description to sources that elaborate further on these topics if you're interested to find out more. For now, that's all there is for this particular video. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, you're watching 0612 TV with NERDfirst.net. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this video and are feeling generous, a donation to this channel will be greatly appreciated. There's a link on screen and in the video description for more details. Meanwhile, please do like, comment, and subscribe. This helps the channel tremendously and gives me the means to do more. Thank you once again, and I'll see you next time.